If I had to choose two free equalizer plugins to accomplish basically all of the tasks I encounter in music production, mixing, and audio editing in general, it would be the ToneBoosters TB Equalizer V3 and the AnalogObsession BlendEQ. I've chosen one digital EQ and one analog EQ. The digital EQ is much better for very precise, surgical cuts and boosts that will allow you to fix problematic things in the music, whereas the analog EQ has much wider boosts and cuts, which I would consider much more musical, as it's very hard to make them sound bad, even with large amounts being boosted and cut. Another thing I really love about the analog EQ is that it forces you to mix with your ears and not with your eyes. And that's something I struggle with, and I think a lot of other people who are interested in audio engineering struggle with, is mixing with their eyes. Here on this EQ Curve Analyzer plugin, you can see the curve I created with the settings I have on BlendEQ. I'm doing a very broad shelf-style boost from about 550Hz up to 20 kHz. A slight dip here from 500 all the way down to 116, and then a slight boost of the low end of the track going all the way down to 20 Hz. I think this EQ curve works perfectly for this track. I'm removing some of the low end frequencies here and some of the mud of the track, boosting the low end a little bit to make up for that, and boosting the high end of the track to add some brightness and sheen to it overall. This is an EQ curve that, to be honest, I probably would not make on a digital EQ plugin. I would look at this and go, there's no way that's right. Why would I be cutting, you know, that much of the track out, and why would I be boosting this much of the high end? But in the context of the mix, it kind of sounds great, and I'll show you that right now. Now I'm going to play back for you the same track that you're hearing in the background. Both of these plugins are on the master bus, and they're currently disabled. I'll bring them in so you can hear how they change the mix. You can hear in the context of this mix, these two EQ plugins make a big difference and make the track sound a lot more professional and finished overall. I have a couple precise edits here on TB Equalizer V3, and BlendEQ is honestly doing most of the work here, boosting the high end and bringing out the presence and clarity, and also removing some of the low mid and low end rumble and mud of the track. I've also used these plugins across basically every single channel in this mix. Okay, so now I get the idea that these two plugins are pretty useful, but what makes them better than other free equalizer plugins out there? For the digital one, TB Equalizer V3, I really like the fact that it has automatic gain compensation, so if you do very large boosts or cuts, the plugin makes up the output gain to match the input gain of the plugin. For example, if I grab this bell here and boost it a ton, it actually changes the other bells and other frequency areas here so that the volume coming out of the plugin is the same as what's going in. Another thing I really like about TB Equalizer V3 is the amount of filter types you have. You can accomplish a lot by messing around with some of these different shapes. It also has a very nice frequency display in the back so you can see what frequencies are sticking out in your mix. You can change the speed, the resolution, and the mode. Another great thing is that it has mid-side mode, so you can choose to selectively equalize the mid-channel, the side channel, or the left and right channels independently. Another really cool thing about this plugin is that it has gain effect, which allows you to mix in a percentage of the amount of equalization that you've done in the first place. So you can see here I have pretty big boosts at 4 and 5. I can just bring down this gain slider to mix in maybe 60% of the original boosts and cuts that I had with these settings. Great feature. And because obviously it's a parametric EQ, you have very precise control over the Q or quality factor of your boosts and cuts, which allows for much more surgical equalization. So what makes BlendEQ special compared to other analog-style equalizer plugins out there? The reason I really like it, not only for the GUI and the simplicity of use, is the fact that it has both the curves of a Neve-style equalizer as well as an API-style equalizer, and it allows you to use these knobs on each band to blend between either a Neve or API-style boost or cut. The most unique characteristic about API-style equalizers is the proportional Q, which means that the more you boost or cut a particular bell, the narrower the Q gets, and the narrower the bandwidth of the cut. You can see here I have it on API setting at 100%, and as I boost gain, watch the bell get narrower. That's a characteristic that does not exist on other styles of analog equalizer. For example, if I go from API and start blending in some Neve style, you can see that the band gets a lot wider and is impacting a lot greater of a frequency range. This plugin's awesome because it allows you to blend a percentage of both the Neve style and API style bell. A great example of the difference between a small booster cut with an API style or Neve style frequency band is that if I start to blend this more towards Neve, you're actually going to see the band get a bit narrower. And if I move it back towards API, you're going to see it gets wider and impacts a greater frequency range. Whereas if you're doing a very large amount of cutting, that API style is going to be a much narrower band, and then as I move it towards Neve, it gets a lot wider. This allows you to accomplish some really unique styles of equalization with this one plugin alone. You can have a Neve style band on the low band here, and an API style band for the mid and the other mid band, and then back to a Neve for the high end band. I haven't seen this on any other plugin, and I absolutely love this. I think it's a super creative thing, and out of all of the AnalogObsession equalizers, this is my favorite by far. The plugin also supports oversampling because it adds harmonics and saturation. There's also a high pass filter if you want to roll off some low end of the track, a low pass filter if you want to roll off some high end of the track, and it allows you to change your input between more of an API style preamp sound or a Neve style preamp sound. These can get dirty pretty quickly, but luckily they're gain compensated, so you could boost a ton of Neve and it's going to make the sound a lot crunchier, but it's not going to increase the gain. Considering I'm using this on the master bus, I would probably stick with a very small percentage of preamp tone being added. But for other tracks, it could be very useful to add a ton of tone to the sound and a lot of harmonic saturation. And you have an output gain here. I really hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you understand my case for why I think these are the two best free equalizer plugins that you can use. In another video, I'm going to go into a bit more detail about how BlendEQ's curves compare to other Neve and API style emulations. If you're interested in that, please stick around or comment what other plugins you want me to check out, and I'll look into them. Thanks a lot for taking the time to check out this video. I recommend trying these plugins out. Try them on your mixes and your productions in general. I think you'll like them. Have a great day.